Sunday, June 20th, we have the moon in Libra, but transiting into Scorpio. So the moon is going to be going void, of course, 7:52 a.m., locking into Scorpio energy, 8:58 a.m., again, Atlantic Standard Time. So a couple of things here. The last couple of days, we've been experiencing the light and fluffy vibes of finding peace, finding harmony, finding balance under the moon in Libra. Anytime that we are shifting into Scorpio energy, things are getting dark. They're getting heavy. Why? Because Scorpio energy needs to jump into the shadow side and shine a bright light on the pain, the suffering, the darkness. Why? Because Scorpio energy is the alchemist of the zodiac. It has the power to illuminate what kind of fragmented energies we're holding on to, what subconscious narratives we're holding on to that are essentially keeping us in a holding pattern. That Scorpio energy is transformative. But first, we have to kind of feel what it is that we need to heal. We have to acknowledge what creeps on in the dark side in order to bring it to light. So most people find it very difficult to adapt to Scorpio energy. Does it feel good? No. It's the detective of the zodiac. We have to ask ourselves the deep-seated questions. We have to probe within our being to see where it is that we're at, what it is that is still creeping around in the dark, where it is that we need to transform the most. And asking those deep-seated questions, you better believe it's going to feel uncomfortable. Now, we have a lot of other things going on other than just the moon's aspects, which I'll jump into here in a second because there's nine of them split up between the Libran energy and the Scorpio energy. But here's the thing. There's so much going on here today. First of all, happy Father's Day. Happy Father's Day to the fathers out there tuning in and listening. And happy Father's Day to the mamas out there listening who had to play both roles. Now, here's the thing. Here's interesting facts here. We are moving into Cancer season. Cancer season ruled over by the moon, very much the mother vibes, right? But the sun is the father vibes. And when the sun moves into Cancer, we are essentially trying to balance out the masculine and feminine energies that we all have inside of us. We all have masculine and feminine energies that we have to tweak. And we're all seeing the changes take place within us, moving out of needing to have control, needing to survive, needing to sit in the pain and suffering, and shifting into surrender, listening to one's intuition, aligning with the cosmos, very much that feminine vibe. So the fact that Father's Day actually takes place on, you know, the very beginnings of this Cancer season, you best believe that we are readjusting our own energies. We've been illuminated to a lot of information over the last couple of weeks that has totally changed the game for us. And because the game is changing, we have to tap into different parts of ourselves. We have to balance the scales. Again, that's what that moon in Libra was trying to do for us in order to have a solid grounding point to launch off of. So, you know, with this energy coming in, trying to balance the scales, what else do we have to take a look at? Well, the sun moving into Cancer triggers for us that summer solstice energy. Again, in the northern hemisphere, the winter solstice in the southern hemisphere. Regardless of where you're at in the world, this is a shift. We are in cardinal energy. This is the initiators of the zodiac when we need to take action on making the changes that we've been illuminated to. So, you know, there are all kinds of megalithic structures out there. Take a look at Stonehenge. There is a reason why our ancestors waited for the solstice to do rituals. And I know that there's a lot of information coming up right now around the occult, around, you know, different rituals that right now, most of the focus is on the bad, the dark, the evil forces. May I remind you that knowledge is knowledge, energy is energy, power is power. There is no kind of control over that other than aligning with good forces and using that knowledge for good, or aligning with the dark forces and using that knowledge for bad. One of the things that I hate seeing right now is the tainted perspective on the occult. Why? Because it's getting a bad rap. They think it's all satanic rituals and, you know, the numerology, using that for negative. I just want people to understand that the power is there. How we choose to use that power is up to us. What wolf we choose to feed within us, the light wolf or the dark wolf, is up to us. So the knowledge is there, the power is there. How we use that is up to us. So this is a big day for celebration, right? You have good people celebrating the good. You have bad people celebrating the bad. But the megalithic structures that have been constructed around the world in order to align with the sun's energy coming in at its peak, because that's what a solstice is. The earth is currently tilting towards the sun. What is the sun for us? It is life force. What are we doing right now? We're being illuminated to where we have to make some changes. Where do the changes need to take place? Well, first of all, they've been taking place in our mental plane, right? We're in Gemini season. We're coming out of Gemini season. We had that great divide. We had new information coming in. What do we got to do now moving into Cancer season? We got to take it down to that heart space. The transformation has to happen within us first before it can manifest outside of ourselves. So the fact that all of this energy is building up here today, and that the moon will actually be in Scorpio at the time of the solstice, you better believe we are doing some deep diving into our heart space, into our psyche. Okay, we are changing, we are transforming. This goes back to our generational and ancestral roots. Okay, we are, if you're alive right now and you're enlightened and you're awake, which you likely are because you're listening to this, you better believe that you have nominated yourself to be alive, to be awake, to be present on the earth during this very pivotal time in humanity's awakening. And most of us are breaking the chain in the generational trauma that we cannot be carrying into new earth. So this is a big deal. So let's jump into some of the different aspects taking place here today. Again, the moon making nine different aspects. The moon in Libra, right out of the gate, wants to have a conversation with the true node to see, okay, you know, we've been trying to balance things. We've been trying to balance our heart. We've been trying to balance our head. We've been trying to make sense of the information that we have and recognizing the information that we still don't have. The true node is saying, okay, you're on the right path. Just stay there, you know, stay in this stable ground. Because for once, for the first time in a long time, you have the right perspective on how to move forward. The moon in Libra goes ahead and squares Pluto. This is a tension point. Pluto, the god of the underworld, really illuminating our shadow self. He does, however, rule over Scorpio. So this is like a little conversation before we really get energized under that Scorpio moon. And Pluto is in Capricorn retrograde, doing a number on the inside of us. What is he doing? He's illuminating the fears, the insecurities, the vulnerabilities, the negative narratives, the mental blocks, the emotional baggage that we refuse to put down. Why? Because we have kind of attached it so deeply to our identity that we don't know who we are without our pain. We don't know who we are without our suffering. My goodness, if you could snap your fingers right now and have all of the negative stripped away from you, who would you be? What excuses would you use for not moving forward, for not standing in your power, for not aligning with your higher self? And so the moon in Libra wants to balance the scales, wants to find peace, wants to find harmony. But this square is a tension point. This is a tough conversation that the moon in Libra is having with Pluto, because Pluto is saying, okay, you've stayed in the shallow end. Are you prepared? Because we're about to do a deep dive in your history, in your trauma, in your pain, in your suffering. And we're about to cut the head off of some of these snakes that you hold on to, yet you scream at the top of your lungs that you are fearful of. How can you hold on to something right? How can you hold on to this and expect there to be change? So the moon in Libra goes ahead and makes an aspect with Neptune. Neptune, heads up, Neptune only has a couple of days still left in a direct position. And, you know, once Neptune goes direct, the universe pretty much bitch slaps the rose-colored glasses off of our face. We're getting huge reality checks here. We can't make sweet, kind scenarios out of our lives. We can't, you know, lie and deceive ourselves once Neptune goes retrograde. But right now, Neptune is still direct, and the moon in Libra goes ahead and just falls into this dreamy, imaginative state where everything is happy and everything is positive and everything is rainbows and butterflies. And you best believe that that is going to be very short-lived here, because the moon in Libra goes ahead, trines the sun, still very much in Gemini at that crisis degree. Right? Once we hit that 29th degree, when the sun is trying to attempt to move out of one sign and into another, this is like a volume all the way up. Now, a trine, granted, is a good aspect, and thankful for that at this particular point. The moon in Libra trining, blending its power, its knowledge with this energy of the sun in Gemini, bringing together the two very extreme choices that we've had to struggle with, bridging the gap between the heart and the head. We are finalizing what it is that we have really been struggling to understand, to comprehend, to visualize while we have been transiting through Gemini season. So this is a powerful zap of energy where, you know, we're thinking we're stable. We're thinking that we're bridging the gap. We're thinking that we're bringing things together, that we're wrapping things up. And then what happens? The moon moves into Scorpio. Then we kind of chill. Now, keep in mind, Scorpio is a water sign. Okay, so our feels are definitely going to be at the top of the list. We are tying in our feels, making connections with our psyche, the subliminal messaging, the conditioning that we've been under, the negative narrative that our subconscious runs without our permission, without our attention, right? And now the moon moving into Scorpio, you best believe we're going to start asking some very serious questions. So what does the moon in Scorpio do first and foremost right out of the gate? He bumps into Mercury. Mercury still very much in a retrograde. He has a couple of days left before he goes direct. Mercury is coming out of his drug state. So let's just go back to that car analogy here. The moon in Scorpio now kind of cuddles in the back seat trying to wake Mercury up. Okay, Mercury, you know, you've been asleep for long enough. You've been incoherent for long enough. You have some visions, you have some information that you have absorbed in your unconscious state that you need to wake up and tell me about so that we can read into how this is all connected, where it is that we're going to kind of connect the dots, make an aha moment between the heart and the head so that we can transform ourselves into a new power that we are going to use for this next season. The moon in Scorpio doesn't have much luck with waking Mercury up. Again, he's still groggy. You know what it's like coming out of a deep sleep or, you know, waking up the next day after a night out, having some fun, having some drinks. You know, it's very euphoric. It's groggy. And so, you know, the moon in Scorpio has a job to do. The moon in Scorpio is very limited in the time here. So, you know, the moon just moves on, has a conversation with Jupiter, okay? Jupiter is in Pisces, a water sign. There's a lot of water coming up. We are moving into a time, Cancer season in particular, where emotions are running high, where we have to listen to our heart space, okay? Our intuition. Jupiter is retrograde, doing a number inside of us, rearranging how it is that we put value on our inner voice, on our connection with the universe, on our spiritual practice. Why? Because things in our outer world, especially the people in our outer world, they got a lot to say. They got a lot of chatter. They got a lot of opinions. What are we realizing right now? They don't know anything. They can't tell us anything about what we should do. Why? Because that is an inner job. So the moon in Scorpio makes this aspect with Jupiter in a retrograde in Piscean waters. And we are now really deep diving into our emotions. We are connecting with the cosmos, with the universe. We will likely feel the need late afternoon to retreat from our worlds, to kind of move inwards. Maybe you find yourself, you know, in a good book or in a good movie. We want to escape reality a little bit, because there's a lot of internal processing going on that, you know, we find it hard to engage in this physical realm when there's a whole world taking place inside of us. So the moon goes ahead and trines Jupiter, makes this beautiful aspect with all of this water, all of this flowy water, asking us to go with the flow, asking us to deep dive, asking the deep-seated questions on how it is we think, how it is we feel. We're not thinking clearly yet, but we're sure as hell feeling lots. It's probably going to be a little bit overwhelming. We have to understand that Jupiter is the great magnifier. He wants us to grow. He wants us to expand. He wants to illuminate for us where it is that we have the most expansion to do. And right now, this is an inside job. So the moon goes ahead, makes an aspect with the true node. This is a difficult conversation because right now we can't be bothered thinking about, you know, the future too much. We're all up in our feels. We got to figure some stuff out right now. We have to take baby steps forward. So the visit isn't very long before the moon in Scorpio goes ahead and squares Mars. Now, fun fact, Mars co-rules over Scorpio. All right. So when these energies come together, there's like a strength here. There's a camaraderie here. Problem is, this is a square, a tension point, a crisis point. What does this sound like? Well, it sounds like Mars in Leo, of course, wants us to be brave and confident and bold, aligning with our heart space, listening to our soul space, going after what it is that we want, need, and desire. We have new passions arising, new sparks being reignited within us, and we want to go after that. However, the moon in Scorpio is like, slow down there, Tiger. We got to figure a couple of things out. You hold on to that passion. You hold on to that fire. You hold on to that desire. However, if we don't recognize where our subconscious conditioning and patterns have self-sabotaged us in the past, we are only going to ruin the new passions and the new desires that we're moving into. So it's almost like we got to pump the brakes, right? We got to pump the brakes, and we have to do a little bit more research, a little bit more detective work in contemplating where it is that we've come from, especially where relationships are concerned. I'm going to tell you, July going to be hot for romance and relationships. So we got to clean up the relationship mess of the past in order to have a fair, clean slate to actually invite new contracts into. So this is what the moon in Scorpio is essentially saying to Mars in Leo, is like, whoa, hold on to that. Let that fire burn heavy in your heart. But we have some reflection to do. We have some dots to connect. We have some aha moments to experience before we can go ahead and start aggressively pursuing our new passions and our desires. But we're going to dream a bigger dream, because the moon in Scorpio aligns with Neptune. Of course, Neptune in its place of power in Pisces, another water sign, again, putting a huge illumination on our dreams, on our visions, on allowing our intuition and our heart space to lead us into this next chapter. And what is the most exciting, and depending on where you're at in the world, right at the end of the day on the 20th, or right at the beginning of the day on the 21st, again, depending on where you're at in the world, that is when the sun moves into Cancer. So we essentially spend all day doing a number between our head and our heart, because Gemini season is wrapping up at its final degree, and we are moving into that Cancer energy, that mothering energy, that soulful energy, intuitional energy. And so it is going to be a little bit chaotic, but we have a full day of all of these adjustments taking place, setting us up for some very, very revealing information as we move throughout the week.